These days, many electronics projects use custom PCBs, and often other people want to have copies of the same PCBs. Now, back in the day, this situation meant that one person would pay a lump sum for a large number of PCBs and then sell the individual PCBs for others who wanted to replicate the project. That was when the cheap prototype PCB manufacturers weren't available and the cost of ordering custom PCBs was too high for small hobby projects. But nowadays, sharing and replicating projects with custom PCBs is much easier and cheaper. In this video, I will show how you can share your projects with others in a way that allows them to order their own copies of the PCBs with just few clicks. The service I'm showing in this video is made by the sponsor of this video, PCBWay.com. PCBWay.com offers basic PCBs starting from just $5 for 10 pieces of 100x100mm PCBs. Here are samples of some, but not all of the different color options available. If your project requires more advanced PCBs, 3D printed parts, or CNC milled parts, don't worry, you can order them from PCBWay.com as well. For all your prototyping and low volume production needs, go check out PCBWay.com for up-to-date information on their offering. I have ordered PCBs from PCBWay many times. Sometimes the PCB design has been perfect, sometimes I've needed to add some botch wires to fix my design errors to avoid needing to order a new set of PCBs. In both of these cases, the PCB design can be shared on the Shared Projects section of the PCBWay.com website. The example I'll show you is this custom protoboard with DC jack and linear regulator. If you want to know how to design a PCB with this kind of grid of pads, I've made a video about it in the past. And I want to emphasize that I recommend you to design your own prototype board that suits your own needs. This design is something I find useful, but your needs may be different. Anyway, I will share this PCB for you to order, in case you want to have copies of this exact version. Because I'm happy with this PCB design and don't need to make any modifications to the design I previously ordered, I don't need to go find the design files. I'll just log into my account on PCBWay.com, go to the completed orders and find the one with this board. This is the one. I can check the gerber view to make sure it's the correct one. And then in the list of ordered PCBs, there is share and sell button under each of the file names. Clicking it will take us to the project sharing page, where the gerber files and the gerber viewer images of each side of the PCB have already been uploaded. Here we can give our project a title, protoboard with MCB1700/LM7800 regulator, and in the category field you must select at least one, but can select up to three categories in your project belongs to. I'll go with breakout board projects and DIY electronics. I think those are fine. Then there is elevator pitch field, which is like introduction or extension to the title. If your title is few words, here you can add full sentence explaining what the project is. Then the gerber files have been transferred from the order page, so in this case I can skip the add gerber file button. But if you are sharing a project you haven't ordered yet, you can upload the gerber files manually. Then there's a question whether I'll allow downloading the gerber files. This really depends on the project. In some projects you may want to control which version others can order, preventing them from ordering old versions. You may also decide to allow others to order copies of your board, but not shared editable files. These decisions are personal decisions, and here is an option to allow or not allow downloading gerber files. Next menu is for selecting the license. If you are not familiar with the licenses, Google is your friend. At least Creative Commons website has easy to understand summaries for the licenses. These licenses will basically tell others what they can do with the shared things. Can they use them commercially? Can they modify them? And how their modified work should be licensed? If we take a look at the couple of the next sections, there's two bill of materials. Now the first one is human readable list of components that will be shown on the shared project page. If user should manually pick the components, this list will help them figure out how many of each components are needed. The next section has upload parts list, or the BOM, bill of materials. This is for CSV file, which is used in PCB assembly. It includes designators, part numbers, and packages. This is a must-have for projects that use the PCBA service, but for projects that will be hand-soldered by hobbyists, the list above is enough. The upload centroid file is for pick-and-place machines used in PCBA service, and the upload other files is for extra information for PCBA service engineers. Neither of those are used in this project. At this point, we have given this project a title, uploaded required gerber files, and listed the needed components. Now we can add detailed description for our project. This field can include text in some useful formats, including lists or headers, but we can also embed YouTube videos and photos. If title was couple of words, elevator pitch was full sentence, make this description as long as you need. Add videos and photos to show things in more details, explain your design choices, and why the project exists in the first place. Lastly, we can add attachment files. There are own sections for source code, schematic, and layout, as well as CAD files for enclosures and other custom parts. This project has none of those. After sharing the project, this is how others will see it. On the right side, there is Add to Cart button where they can order the board. Above that, on top, there's title of the project, details of the PCB, and then the elevator pitch I wrote. I only used photos of Gerber viewer that were automatically uploaded, so that is what we are seeing. Only surprise here is that the description field starts with the project title. I didn't add that, it came automatically. All in all, this seems to be easy way of creating simple but efficient project page for our custom PCB design. Other users can click a button, select preferred colors and quantities, and order the board just like any other PCBs. I think this is simple and effective feature on PCBway.com website. Thanks for watching. See you next video. Thanks. Bye.